Thank you, Saki. I am super proud to present the second scenario of FC Demo Day. Here, we will demonstrate the collaborative and hard work done by three national projects from Romania, Greece, and France. They will illustrate how EPSI can support student mobility in a cross-border journey to simplify the process of issuing and verifying bachelor, master, and PhD verifiable credentials. In this scenario, Anca, a Romanian student, is keeping her educational credentials from Timișoara in order to apply for a master program in Athens, and after its completion, to engage on a PhD in Lille. After that, we will discover how an employer can check an EPSI compliant verifiable credential in a very pragmatic and didactic way using a web application. And now the floor is yours, Carmen.
Thank you very much, Jose Manuel. Hello, everyone. I'm very glad and honored to be here with you to be able to present the wonderful work together of three teams from three countries, Romania, Greece, and France. My name is Carmen Holotescu. I'm a professor of computer science from Romania. Here are the topics I would like to share with you today. First of all, a few things about the three teams. The three teams implement in their countries very innovative projects. From Romania, the project is EPSI for Road, connecting Romania through blockchain, a project that aims to create an extendable ecosystem to facilitate the awareness and the adoption of EPSI in the country. The partners being the Executive Agency for Higher Education, Research, Development and Innovation Funding from Bucharest, and the very well-known and big university, Politehnica University of Timișoara. From Greece, the team implement the project eLedger, Hellenic Distributed Ledger Technology Infrastructure, a project that has as goals to establish a solid pillar for the development of the European blockchain partnership in Greece, and also to support the participation of Greek stakeholders to EPSI. Related to France, the project is AFR.EPSI, ready to use academic credentials on EPSI, a project that has as aims to deliver verifiable digital diplomas on EPSI to provide, to support universities with tools for a large-scale use. In this project, the leader is University of Lille, and the partners are Guy Prenater and BC Diploma as technical operators. You can find more information about our project and about our teams on the websites of the three projects. Now, speaking about the context of our scenario and the objectives, the problems that we want to solve, and the ambitions and objectives for the cross-border project. Here, there are some statistics related to the number of students in the three countries for different levels of education, and we can see that each year, tens or even hundreds of thousands of students come from abroad to study in our countries. So the objective of our project is to support student mobility by applying EPSI use cases in a cross-border scenario, coming with the simplification for the process of issuing, verifying bachelor, master, or doctoral diploma credentials. So we have a very big audience. We speak about all the students in Europe that want to apply for a PhD study or for a master study, or also to apply for a job. The objectives are to simplify the administrative processes, to enhance trust, and also to increase efficiency. And how we could use, how we could solve all this by using the EPSI use cases, self-sovereign identity, and also diploma management. Which were the actors and their roles? as trusted accreditation organizations, there were ministries and organizations in our countries, Ministry of Education and also the agency of from Bucharest, UEFI-CEDEI. From Greece, there are Ministry of Education, Ministry of Digital Governance, GRNET, and from France, there is the Ministry of National Education. Trusted issuers were the three universities, from Romania, Polytechnica University of Timișoara, from Greece, University of Athens, and from France, University of Lille. All the students can be holders in this scenario, and we'll see a demonstration from a Romanian student called Anca. And as verifiers, there are the other universities, any university in Europe, or any company in which students want to apply for a job. Now, about our scenario, what we have developed. In our scenario, Anca, who is a Romanian student graduating from Bachelor Studies from the Polytechnica University of Timișoara, wants to continue her studies with a master program at University of Athens, and then she wants to apply for a doctoral degree in France at University of Lille. So, three countries appear in this scenario. The actors are the three pioneering universities, Polytechnica University of Timișoara, University of Athens, and University of Lille. And the types of the credentials that are issued are student ID and also verifiable attestation and verifiable diploma. As a wallet, we have used a powerful EPSI compliant wallet, which is called Vault ID. Here we can see the representation of our cross-border scenario on the map of Europe. We can see that Polytechnica University of Timișoara is the issuer for student ID and for diploma credential. University of Athens acts both as verifier and issuer for diploma credentials, and the same University of Lille acts as a verifier and an issuer for verifiable credentials. And now, the demonstration will be narrated by Anca, a Romanian student, and we'll see the demonstration from her own point of view.
My name is Anca, and I graduated with my bachelor's studies from the Faculty of Electronics and Telecommunications of Polytechnica University of Timișoara, Romania. To further my studies, I want to enroll in the master's program in data science and information technologies offered by the University of Athens. Let's see how I can easily enroll in this program using the potential and trust provided by the European blockchain services infrastructure. To make use of EBSI capabilities for verifiable credentials, I have to store my credentials in an EBSI compliant wallet, so I set up a Vault ID wallet, obtaining a decentralized ID, DID. To start, I will authenticate to the Polytechnica University of Timișoara portal to request the issuance of my student ID together with my bachelor's diploma. Both my student ID and my bachelor's diploma will be stored in my wallet.
And now we can see in Anca's wallet the information specific to the two verifiable credentials, her student ID and bachelor diploma.
Now I can authenticate on the University of Athens portal. The portal authenticates myself by presenting my student ID from the wallet, which was issued by Polytechnica University of Timișoara. I can now present and verify my bachelor's diploma on the University of Athens portal. The university verifies the authenticity of my diploma and enrolls me in the master's program in data science and information technologies. After successfully finishing this program, I request the University of Athens to issue my master's diploma, which will be stored in my wallet as well.
Now in Anka's wallet, the third verifiable credential is stored, and we can see the specific information.
Being an ambitious person, I decided to apply for a PhD degree at the University of Lille, France. Thanks to my wallet, the registration process and the verification of my diplomas was done in a flash. After 3 years, I have a PhD in computer science after defending my doctoral thesis, Applications of Machine Learning in Cybersecurity. So now I request the university to issue the PhD diploma, and here is what I receive in my wallet from the University of Lille. I want to apply for a vacancy in a private company. The company assistant has received via email my diploma verifiable credential, and they need to verify the authenticity and the integrity of this information. In this screen, we can see all the information for my PhD certificate. The University of Lille has provided an open source service where organizations can verify verifiable credentials issued on EBSI. We can verify my student ID, which was the one issued by Politehnica University of Timișoara, for which all the policies are valid, as well as the credential. We can then verify the PhD certificate credential issued by University of Lille, and the credentials are valid as well. The signature, schema, the IDs, and dates are all valid and issued by a trusted authority. Being issued on EBSI as verifiable credentials, I can easily share my 3 diplomas to be verified by any third entity across borders with greater authenticity and trust, and I'm the owner of my data.
I hope what Anka just narrated was a good demonstration for our work together, the second cluster, how our group was called during the EPSI Early Adapters program. Now let's see the roadmap and the key challenges we had to face, and also we managed to solve. First of all, our scenario addressed the challenge of student mobility in Europe for services requiring student identity or degree verification. A first challenge was to use the same personal student wallet in 3 countries and 3 universities. How we could solve this? By using the World ID wallet, a very performant EPSI compliant wallet. This wallet was used in this project successfully, as you could see in the demonstration. And we have benefited of all the professional support of the World ID team. We want to thank them again. And also, it was possible this because Politehnica University of Timișoara issued an a decentralized ID and also verifiable identity attributes, which were used in the whole scenario. Then the second challenge was to issue EPSI compliant credentials recognized in other countries. Here, the 3 participating countries have issued Europa's diplomas valid on the European blockchain services infrastructure. This was possible because we have a very close collaboration, and also we have benefited of all the constant and professional support of the EPSI team. The third challenge was to allow a university department or recruiter to verify a credential submitted by a student. And this was possible because the French partner built a very good open source verification service, which is online and could be used by any of you. And Anca, just show you this open source verification service. And on this slide, you can find, when you will receive the presentation, the link to this service. So this service was built by the French team, and it was possible because World ID is an open source project, to which also the other teams in this cluster brought their contributions. Now, our call to action. Of course, all the three teams want to continue their work with EPSI using the experience gained during this EPSI Early Adapters program. Also, all the teams want to continue and disseminate their project, want to organize together different conferences and workshops, and also want to publish joint articles. Now, speaking about the project in Romania, EPSI Foro, here we are implementing a national system for issuing university diplomas and micro-credentials on EPSI, a system which is integrated with the National Student Enrollment Registry. Also, we deliver 5 MOOCs, 5 massive online courses related to blockchain and EPSI, and also towards the end of the project, we want to come with policy proposals for the Ministry of Education. The same as the colleagues in the other two countries, we want to collaborate with you, with European universities and organizations, in order to adapt EPSI. Speaking about the project in Greece, eLedger project, this project will roll out the EPSI and will support Greece stakeholders, allowing delivery of cross-border public services based on the blockchain technology and enhancing the way citizens, government, and businesses interact. The same, GRNet would like to cooperate with several European universities and stakeholders to make use of the verifiable credential services and ease the cross-border interactions. Speaking about the project in France, FR EPSI and University of Lille teams provide French universities with an open source application to automate the issuance of blockchain credentials diplomas. Also, the project team will deploy a compliant EPSI wallet at the University of Lille before the end of this year. Furthermore, the team members hope for a wider collaboration with several member states and universities to deploy the use of a wallet based on the European student identifier. Each year, thousands of European students apply to study in a foreign country, building their personalized learning journey. Let's support them in building this learning journey, the same as Anca did, by using the EPSI capabilities. How these learning journeys could be flexible, could be performant, could be trusted, and could be continuous. I'm sure that in this online space, there are many new adapters for EPSI. So we kindly invite you to reach out to us in order to learn together from our experience and to collaborate in building cross-border scenarios for EPSI verifiable credentials. You can find here the websites of our project, where there are many details about our projects and our social media accounts. And also, please use this email addresses in order to get in touch with us. I cannot end my presentation without thanking again to the professional EPSI and World ID teams. Also, I have to say again, congrats and thank you to all the members of the three teams who built together this scenario. To Perrin and Luc from France, to Fei, Poteinos and Panos from Greece, and to Elena, Diana, Gabriela, Victor, Andrei, Cosmin and Radu from Romania. Thank you for your attention.